Hey y'all, so my voice is kind of gone, so you're gonna have to bear with me. Probably gonna have to switch to a voiceover here in a little bit, but I've already prepped and primed my eyes. I already have my concealer on and it's set, and so we can just go ahead and just jump into this like pinky, rosy, smoky eye. It's pretty popular, especially with this palette, but let's just go ahead and get started. Alright, so to start off with, I'm going to pick up Dusty Rose. This is really pretty, like mauvey purpley shade. And I'm gonna take this on a smaller blending brush. It's a little bit dense. It's probably bigger than I normally do. Actually, I'm gonna pick up the smaller one. And all my brushes are super dirty, so there's that. So I'm picking up Dusty Rose and I'm just gonna buff this into the outer part of my eye. And I'm gonna kind of drag it in a little bit because I kind of wanted to do like a cut crease today. Like a cut crease, smoky eye. So I am gonna drag this in a lot farther than I normally would. Alrighty, I don't know if I'm gonna do a full cut crease or not. I guess I will. So, I guess to start off with, to build up the crease just a little bit more, I'm gonna pick up a second shade with this looser fluffy brush. This is my Moda Pro BMX 430 crease brush. And I'm going to pick up a little bit of orange soda. I don't want to make it too warm or anything. I just kind of want to blend and blend and blend. I want this to be completely seamless. It's okay if we stray outside of these lines because I'm going to go in with a makeup wipe and just clean up that that outer edge. Right, now I'm taking my ColourPop No Filter Concealer and I'm going to first dot this on the eye, and then this is in the Nicole Guerrero tip. I'm gonna look up. This is for hooded eyes. Especially works for us just because it actually gives us a lid and you can actually see it. And then I'm gonna pick a flatter shader brush, one that's clean. And I'm just gonna buff this all, carve it out a little bit, all over the lid. You see, even when I have my eye open, it still looks like I have so much more of a lid, even though it's kind of gone up into my crease. If you have wide open eyes, you probably just need to focus on your crease. It's just I don't. I have hooded eyes, and so I gotta use some tips and tricks for this. That I know a lot of people that will set this, so I'm just gonna set it and then we'll probably just use Max Fix Plus because I want this shade to come off as like super metallic and not just kind of like a shimmery shade. I'm gonna set it using Tempera, which is this shade right here. This is what I used to set my whole eyelid earlier. now to start off the actual like eye part of it, I'm gonna take Max Fix Plus, and then I'm gonna spray my brush. I'm just gonna end up using that same flat shader brush that we did before. This is by Crown, and I don't see any number on it, but I sprayed the brush, and now I'm gonna dip into Sultry, which is right here, that beautiful rosy shade. I'm gonna start off with that shade. Just pick it up. Come off real heavy. Part open because we're just going to go over it with a pinkier shade anyway. And I'm going to pick that up some more. Okay, now that we have that color stamped down, I'm going to spray my brush, but I'm going to flip it over. And I missed my brush the first spray, in case you're wondering. And we're going to pick up Rose Pink, which is this really, really pretty little pinky shade up here. Focus this on the inside and buff, kind of like lightly tap it towards this middle section and kind of feather. So I'm just like barely tapping on this. I'm just feathering it this way. Doing the same with the other eye. Then I'm gonna take this flat shader brush one more time. I'm gonna run it over this line. I know there should be a line because it is a cut crease, but personally it slightly bothers me. So I'm just gonna kinda like go over that a little bit. There should be a line with a cut crease. There is a sharp disconnect. That's always how they are. And I'm just gonna get rid of that harsher line up in the top. Now what I'm gonna end up doing is I'm gonna pick up this brush, and I'm gonna pick up Cypress Umber because I want this to be very dark and smoky. And I'm just gonna start off with this shade, and I'm put it on a flatter, fluffier brush. See how like fluffy it is at the same time? It's pretty flat. I'm focusing this only on this outer V. So I'm not dragging this to the middle of my eye, I'm only doing the outer V. And I'm keeping it very controlled because this still is a cut crease. And now I'm picking up this other side right here, which is a lot smaller, very precise. And I'm picking up Noir, which is the black in this palette. And I'm picking that up. And I'm gonna focus this on the very, very, very outer edge. And work my way slowly up the cut crease. Not even coming as far as the dark brown, but still etching a little bit of darkness in this outer edge. Flip it over and take that flatter, fluffier side. I'm slightly gonna blend. Just kind of feather like we did with the pink. And kind of zigzag pattern my brush. Just so it blends seamlessly into that dark brown that we had. And now we're done with the top of the lid. And so what I end up doing, is I will usually go in with a makeup wipe. And I'm gonna swipe this underneath my eyes. And I'm gonna drag it up toward my brow just to get rid of anything that's gonna make our eyes look like downcast or droopy. But I like to almost scoop it from like underneath of my eye towards my hairline, because sometimes you can get a little crazy and you can accidentally shorten the colors right here. And if you have a dipped in face like I do, then once you go up past that little eyebrow line, you're gonna look like you shortened your makeup and it's gonna look really weird. So you gotta make sure when you're dragging that you drag this way, you know, like towards your eyebrow, but not like straight up. Because if you go straight up, it's gonna look ridiculous and it's gonna cut off your eye shape. Now to finish up the eyes, I'm gonna go ahead and go in with Dusty Rose first. I'm gonna be using a pencil brush for this and just drag this up underneath the lash line. It doesn't matter that it's a little bit messy, just because I don't care if this is a little bit more smoked out, a little bit more dragged around. I'm gonna connect the outer edge of this and then drag it in. And then I'm gonna take this, it's a little bit denser, but it's still flat. This is the Crown Brush, and I don't see any sort of name on it. This is like a professional set, I'm pretty sure. So I'm not even sure if people can actually buy it that aren't professionals. And I'm taking Orange Soda, and I'm just gonna run that up under all of it, just to buff it out even more and blend. And I'm going back in with that pencil brush, and I'm picking up Cypress Umber, which is that dark brown. I'm I'm connecting the two and dragging it all up underneath the lash line and stopping when I get to the end of the lash line. And now I'm gonna take that brush that we used before. It has this like very small flat edge, and I'm picking up Noir one more time. And this is a smaller, more precise brush. And I'm connecting that outer edge and just dragging this about, not even halfway, but a little bit more than a third. And now that my eyes are nice and smoky, I'm going to pick up Glistening here. And I'm using one of these weird little brushes that you get in like all those little cheap kits. They're like little sponge ones, but they actually work so well for the inner corner highlight. And I'm using Glistening, which is this really pretty like shimmery shade right here. And now y'all know what I like to do. I've been using this mascara for a while now. This is the Tartist Lash Paint. And I'm gonna put this on, and then I'm gonna put on some lashes. I'm gonna use the ones that we used in our last one. I believe these are the Nicole Guerrero, if I can find which ones they are. I don't know if these are the same ones or not. What I end up doing is I usually put them in this little like metal container thing, and then I reuse them. And no, I don't know which ones they are. So we'll just work with that. I'm gonna put on the Nicole Guerrero Casually Glamorous. These are the Allure lashes that she made with them. And then we'll be back for lips. So I'm gonna pick up this lipstick by Sephora. It's like their Lip Story. This is in the shade Tan Lines. Put that on, and then I'm gonna put Moonchild on top of that. I still wish it were a little bit pinker, honestly, but I'm just not gonna worry about it. So anyway, this is the finished makeup look. I hope y'all like it. If y'all like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. I did an Instagram little like story thing, and a lot of y'all liked the full faces more. I got a Natasha Denona palette, and I wanted to do a 2-in-1 makeup look, even though I know y'all like full faces more. And I'm only gonna do those every now and then. I'm not gonna do them like as much as I do the full faces. But anyway, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.